burn, and these winds shifting, and it looks like they're still blowing in a direction that we don't want them to be blowing in, right?
Yeah, absolutely the wrong direction. And unfortunately, these winds are as strong, at least here, as they have been all afternoon, sweeping from west to east across Superior. You just heard Rob mention about Spanish Hills. That's essentially McCaslin and South Boulder Road. To give you guys a scope of the size of this fire, that's 12 miles north of where we are standing right now. To get to Spanish Hills from here, you have to go through all of Superior. You have to cross 36. You have to go through all of Louisville, and that's how you get there to Spanish Hills. My in-laws live there, just texted me telling me their front fence and hillside is on fire. So just unbelievable the scope and magnitude of this fire in size when we talk about how many different communities are being impacted by this fire right now. Unfortunately, I can tell you we have seen structures burning, likely homes burning in this subdivision directly in front of us. You can see, and Jerry, maybe we can pan all the way out to look at this cloud of smoke to the right. You can see that thick black color in that cloud of smoke, and that is absolutely not what we want to see, likely indicative of probably multiple homes burning. You heard Ashley talking about homes burning in Louisville. I just spoke with a woman who's watching here on Highway 28, watching the fire spread. She was able to get back into her home about an hour ago to rescue some pets that were inside. She said her home was filled with smoke. She's about about a mile east of where Ashley was just live from, right there at the rec center. So that shows the incredible trajectory of this smoke that is billowing to the east, and obviously just catastrophic, the damage that is likely occurring in Louisville, Superior, and surrounding Boulder counties from this fire. Guys, amazingly windy up here right now, actually, you know what I want to do right now is, Jerry, if we can pan down to this neighborhood. Jeremy, we were talking about this earlier, about evacuations in this neighborhood. You can see a bunch of police cars now entering this neighborhood. It looks like about a dozen police cars coming into this neighborhood, likely doing door-to-door checks like we've seen in those surrounding communities. Look at this line of police cars coming in. I'm sure making sure everyone is out of this area. Because unfortunately, as you mentioned to Jeremy at the top of this hit, that wind has shifted to the...
All right, Evan, we'll stay with you. We're losing your microphone. We want to stay with this picture, though. These flames and this smoke getting perilously close to these homes. Once again, as you can see in this live picture in Superior near McCaslin, not too far from US 36, Clint Folsom is the mayor of Superior. He joins us on the phone right now. And, Mayor, I know you're busy. We won't take up too much of your time. I just wonder if you can get us a better picture of what's gone on in Superior this afternoon. We're hearing all kinds of stories about businesses destroyed. Can you give us a sense of that right now?
We are still under a mandatory evacuation order for the town, and I'm currently with the sheriff's officials and manager. We're doing a survey around town, and we're watching structures burn. It's a really unfortunate situation here.
On social media, there are all kinds of talk about the Tesla dealership, hotels under construction, homes. Can you confirm any of that? Have those been burned or destroyed?
We're about to drive up to that here shortly. We do have, the hotel has, I do believe the hotel is burned, but we're still surveying the rest of those areas.
Can you give us any, I know, obviously, you're still getting information here. Can you give us any sense of the number of structures burned or homes burned yet?
Yeah, unfortunately, I think it's going to be in the hundreds. I don't have any more specifics than that.
Okay, got it.
Mayor, what about in terms of any injuries that you may have heard about since the start of these fires?
No injuries. I think not aware of any injuries.
Okay.
At this point.
We're looking at a live picture, I believe, not far from the Rock Creek subdivision. Obviously, a lot of people live over there. What do you know about what's gone on there? What kind of threat they're under right now?
It's the entire town still under a mandatory evacuation order, and there's definitely flames around Rock Creek. And I'm guessing there's been some structures affected, but don't have details on.
Okay. Yeah, understood too. And obviously, those businesses over near the Costco and the Target. Any word about damage to those?
We're moving in that direction. The Tesla building is still there, but the Element Hotel is not. I think the Costco and Target are still there. I think we've lost our town hall. Town hall's still there, barely. Our museum, our mining museum, is gone, and several homes on the very west side behind the Costco and Target are gone.
Okay, so homes destroyed on the west side of town behind the Costco and Target, and the mining museum is destroyed. Town hall is intact, and the Tesla dealership is intact as well.
That's correct.
But tell me, that the Element Hotel, is that the one that was currently under construction?
No, it's been open about 2 years.
Okay.
It's been open a couple of years. It was our only hotel.
And it's been destroyed.
Yeah. Gone.
It's gone. Okay, wow, this is devastating news. We're speaking live with Clint Folsom, Mayor of Superior, as he gives us sort of a live play-by-play of what's going on in his town. And we're struck, Mayor, I'm sure you are too, by the fact that this would hit a suburban community the way that it has this time around. You just don't see this very often.
No, you don't. And, you know, we're fortunate to live next to a lot of great open space. But with that, it certainly comes the risk of fire when you have conditions like we've got. I mean, these winds, just the amount of dirt that is just being blown around. I mean, we're out here now, and it's unprecedented, the amount of this wind, this sustained winds are just ferocious.
Yeah. All right, Mayor Folsom, Mayor of Superior, we thank you so much for your time, sir. I do not know if you are a praying man, but I can tell you that there is an entire Colorado community that is praying not just for you, but for the community of Superior as well tonight.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks for taking the time to join us. Just devastated for the mayor and the people of that town. Again, so much destruction there. The mining museum, the Element Hotel, the only hotel in the town of Superior, destroyed. Homes destroyed behind the Costco and the Target there as the devastation continues. And we know that a roof has collapsed not too far from all of this devastation, too. We want to get to Michael Konopasek. He's there where that happened. Where are you, Kano, and what exactly happened?
Jeremy, we're near Sims and 64th in Arvada. Go ahead and take a look at this discount tire shop. It looks like a tornado hit this place. The roof is on the ground. Firefighters just finished sweeping up some glass. In fact, they're continuing to shovel some glass off of this parking lot here. Now, let me tell you, we just arrived here, so we're still trying to learn some information from officials. But I can tell you that we don't see any rush of urgency with any ambulances. So there's no sign from what we can see of injuries. That doesn't mean there aren't any injuries, but we just don't see any signs of any currently. But this building is destroyed. I mean, the whole roof, as you can see, down onto the ground there. And if we can pan over onto the side here, you can just see the tires sticking up here. Again, this is a discount tire shop. We can only, of course, assume that this would be from the wind, but we're still working to understand exactly everything that happened here. The wind continues to blow, though. It is so strong.
Michael, and I think that really helps tell the story of what we are seeing unfold today. It has been those ferocious winds that have pushed these fires from sort of more rural areas into these subdivisions and into these communities. Just look at that roof on the ground right now. And again, hopefully there are no injuries related to the scene that Michael is covering right now. But to the right of your screen, we are looking at pictures from the town of Superior, where we have seen those flames, to the left of your screen now. I'm getting so close to those homes. That is where our Evan Krugel has been live from throughout the evening. We are now, it is 4:40 right now in the evening. In about 20 minutes, we do expect to hear an update from the Boulder sheriff. And from my understanding, Governor Polis will also be a part of that press conference as well. So hopefully we can get a better understanding in terms of the damage that we're seeing here and what they want residents to know at this point, as well as any injuries that we know about right now.
The image you're looking at live right now is on the south side of Superior there. It's near McCaslin, just south of US 36. You know, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of homes, most of them new in newer developments and subdivisions just built over the last few years. Now in the path of this storm, as these winds continue to shift, and we've seen them blowing toward the east, which is not at all what folks who live near there had wanted to see this afternoon. And looking at that one house sort of in the center of your screen, just a little bit to the left of center, it looks like a cream-colored house there. Those flames awfully close to it. And we know hundreds now, hundreds of structures in the town of Superior have burned. This according to the mayor, who confirmed that live on Fox 31 just moments ago. He told us the town's mining museum, a bunch of homes, the only hotel in town, the Element Hotel, they've all been destroyed. We don't know about other businesses. He, as we spoke with him, was doing sort of a tour through town, driving around, seeing what was happening. And he, of course, paying attention to the very images that we're showing you right now, too. They never expected anything like this in a town like Superior. And he talked about the open space that they all love. It's part of the reason you live in a place like Superior. And now much of it destroyed by this fire this afternoon.
You know, and unfortunately, we're seeing probably a similar situation playing out in Louisville. We've been tuning back into Ashley Michaels, who's been live in front of the Louisville Senior and Recreation Center that we saw live on TV, completely destroyed by some of the flames there, as well as a home. Last time we checked in with Ashley, she unfortunately had to move because she was concerned for her own safety. So hopefully we'll get back to her soon. But, you know, I think that the point in me saying this is, in other words, we can expect similar damage reports out of the town of Louisville as well.
It's for sure. Yeah, it's just across 36 from Superior. They were sort of in the clear until just a few hours ago when they were forced to evacuate, too. And as you know, folks in Broomfield, just a little bit to the east, are now in pre-evacuation orders, at least the folks who live closer to Flatiron Crossing Mall. They have set up an evacuation center for Broomfield residents just in case. It's at First Bank Center, that big event venue just off 36 as you head to the north there. So if you feel compelled to go there now, you're certainly welcome. Although, again, these are just pre-evacuations for the people in Broomfield. But as we look live here, Superior, these are the folks in the crosshairs of these two fires that have burned out of control. I should say at least two fires. It could be more than that by now, but it's the Middle Fork and the Marshall Fire in Boulder County this afternoon, kicked up hours ago, fueled by these massive wind gusts at times over 100 miles per hour, and still at last check, gusting to 70, 80 plus.
Yeah, and if you're looking at that picture, you can see just how quickly that smoke is moving, and that gives you an idea of just how fast these winds are moving. I want to see if we can get an update from Chief Meteorologist Dave Frazier, who's been here with us for their breaking news coverage, to give us an update on what those wind speeds are looking like. And I think the question on everybody's mind is watching right now is, when are they going to get better, Frazier?
Yeah, well, okay, so we are literally, technically, we're about 2.5 minutes from sunset, but then you have to wait a little while for the sun's energy to kind of disappear. If you guys want to put the weather computer in the little box, I can show you updated on the winds. You've been hearing from all our crews out there that the wind just got a little more ferocious. So these are the current speeds that you're seeing. We're still focusing in here. You can see the speed strong in and around the Boulder area. And as I mentioned earlier, right around sunset for another hour beyond that, what happens is the sun's energy kind of lets the rock in the mountains and the foothills cool. That cools the air adjacent to it. That air becomes very dense, and you get this last blast of air, which will come down the face of the foothills and move out. That's what you're seeing here on the right-hand side of your screen in the picture. You're seeing that wind kind of turn a little more ferocious. Here's the front range, and you can see it right in here. Here's your stronger wind speeds up over the higher elevation. Here's the gusts. They're rolling out across the bottom of the speed. Now, we can only pick up the gusts when it hits the sensors, but our reporters are indicating that it's stronger now than it was, say, an hour or so ago. And that times out with sunset. So here's what's going to happen. The good news is, as the sun sets, watch the next 2 hours as the stronger speeds retreat back up the mountains. So you get this disconnect from the winds rolling down the face of the foothills, blasting out west of I-25 and through the city. Once the sun sets, you'll get that to retreat back up. That should allow the areas around the fire for the wind to come down. I'm not talking about it going calm. I'm just saying the strong gusts of 60, 70 miles per hour that are fanning the flames you see in your picture right here, that will start to come down just a little bit. So that's what we're looking for as we continue. Now, there's the smoke plume that we've been tracking all afternoon. It's here on the northwest side. We had the wind come out of the west, blowing the smoke to the east. Then it turned for a brief period for about an hour and pushed the flames to the south. south. Well, now that wind is rolling off the foothills again, and it's fanning the flames back to the east. So some of these areas, we already watched this area burn through earlier. This is Evan's camera. We saw it burn through the natural grasses, then it kind of retreated off to the west. Well, now it's blowing back over those same areas once again. And unfortunately, it looks like it's hitting a couple of homes where you see the black smoke there. The intense flames in here is just unbelievable. This is the hottest part of the fire right now, as you can see in and around the Superior and Louisville area. You can understand why they're evacuating. And Jeremy had mentioned maybe a couple of fires, certainly positive in here. These are two different smoke plumes out there. So what you're going to get is embers kind of skipping around, hitting homes and everything like that. So there are, while we have two names, those are the origins of the fire. There's been multiple fires skipping around from time to time to time. And that's unfortunate to see in the picture here right now, guys, is that the black smoke tells me that something other than just grasslands and trees is burning.
Unfortunately, when we do expect to hear from officials at 5 p.m., whatever numbers they give us at that time, unfortunately, those numbers can quickly change over the next hours.
The hope, as Dave said, is that these winds will die down. It certainly hasn't been the case so far, and Rob Lowe can attest to that. He's live up there near Superior, blowing around in the wind at this very moment. And, Rob, it looks like that smoke continues to blow your way.
Boy, Jeremy, as you were saying, we're hoping the winds would die down. Just the opposite. I didn't think it could get worse, and it has. And the winds and the smoke is so dark and so thick that you can't tell right now, but there are actually three or four homes currently burning behind us in that Spanish Hills subdivision. It is really, really picked up. I mean, just moments ago, I think my photographer, Mike Roberts, is trying to zoom in to where you can see a house on fire currently burning, but it is an unbelievable sight. This smoke and these winds are just unforgiving. We're being told that we've got to move. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's a huge wall of orange flame heading our way, so
okay,
we're going to have to move.
You get to safety.
Get
move, move, move.
Wow, it's just on the other side of that charge.
Bob,
we're going to have to move, guys.
Okay, yep. Get out of there. Yep, no
worries.
We'll
check back in with you in just a little bit. We were actually just talking to Ashley Michaels about 20 minutes ago. She also had to move. She found herself in a similar situation. Ashley, looks like you're in a safe spot now. Talk to us about, you know, what's happened over the last 20 minutes.
Yeah, Eric and Jeremy, we moved back just a little bit. We're still along Via Appia Road, but you can see I'm inside of our news vehicle right now. And that's because we were going to step outside in the parking lot of, we're in, what's the name of this church that we were at just about an hour ago? We're in a church on Tyler and Via Appia. I can't remember the exact name of the church. We were here about an hour ago, and this was a very safe spot, and we figured, you know what, we'll come right back here. We started to get out to do our live shot in the parking lot here, and there were embers literally raining down, falling on us all in this parking lot. They're landing in the grass. We saw one land on the sidewalk. They've been all in the parking lot here, and it's really concerning because, I don't know, maybe if we can show the camera out this way, there are homes all along right in here. So it's very concerning to see these embers from nearby fires blowing into this location right here. The wind is absolutely fierce right now. And so that is certainly a challenge when it comes to putting a stop to this massive fire that we're having right now. But yeah, that's why we have to be in the car. Now, just look, take a look right out my window right here. I'm told there was another ember that just fell into the parking lot. Lots of debris falling on our windshield. It's tough to tell right now how close or how far the actual flames are to where we are, but we're seeing that thick billowing smoke coming from right behind these homes you see on the edge of the parking lot of this park. Very, very concerning. And that's exactly why we chose to stay in the car here and stay safe instead of getting outside where that smoke is super, super thick and those embers falling on us right here and now. Jeremy and Erica.
All right, Ashley, thank you. As we look live here, right side of your screen, this is Superior, where hundreds of homes have been lost. This, according to the mayor, and we are watching them. And again, apologies for the bouncy camera. It is so windy out there. We couldn't keep this thing still if we really wanted to, and we do, believe me. But it is so windy out there, and these flames are being fueled by that wind, and they're getting ever so close to these homes. And you have to think that that 100-plus number of structures destroyed in Superior is only going to grow this evening as these case, flames get so much closer to this subdivision. And again, for those unfamiliar, this is south of US 36 near McCaslin. It's in that area where there's a lot of subdivisions and newer homes, and they are all in the path of these winds today.
And I just want to let our viewers know at home, but for anybody who's watching and wants concrete answers as to what we're dealing with, we do hope to get some in the next few minutes. From our vantage point, we can see a whole slew of live feeds that we have going on right now as part of our coverage, and we can see officials are starting to set up for that press conference that we expect to start right at 5 p.m., where we do expect the sheriff of Boulder to be a part of that and the governor of Colorado as well. So hopefully we can get an idea. Several questions. You know, what is the firefight like? What injuries are we talking about here? How many structures have been lost? And what we can expect over the next few hours as well.
Looks like that home on the right side of your screen, that cream-colored one, is about to go up in flames. It's surrounded by flames on at least two sides as the winds continue to blow these embers in that direction. And this home is probably going to be lost over the next couple of minutes with nothing anybody can do. And firefighters, again, thankfully went door to door in this neighborhood hours ago getting people out. And as far as we know, nobody in Superior, at least, has been injured, this according to the mayor there. And we are thankful that everybody is away from these homes. We know they went door to door, but man, it just really breaks your heart when you see now this house on fire, clearly. And this is somebody's home. You know, here we are at the end of the year, and holidays just over with, and this is the last thing anybody expected to happen here on a Thursday afternoon.
Yeah, you just said it, Jeremy. This is absolutely heartbreaking. You feel so much for, you know, if the family is watching this live unfold right now, these are memories that are gone and can never be brought back. And hopefully what we've been seeing in some of these neighborhoods from our live crews out in Superior and Louisville is that these are the ghost towns at this point. So, you know, the hope is pets and family members did evacuate on time. And, you know, the hope here is that there's no loss of life. That's what we, you know, fire crews and everybody in emergency management wants to prevent here. This makes me think of a tweet because I know I feel this way right now. People watching this live unfold right now are thinking, what can I do to help? There are ways to help, and we will have an entire web story filled with details about how you can help. I know earlier today I saw one of the police departments saying, hey, don't call us about how you can help right now. But if you do want to help right now, there's always the Colorado Red Cross. They are so big when it comes to helping people dealing with these kinds of emergency situations. And unfortunately, you are seeing that house being completely enveloped by those flames right now and being destroyed.
We just saw this fire explode live on TV as we approach the 5 o'clock hour. This is live continuous breaking news coverage of two fires burning in Boulder County, forcing evacuations in Superior and Louisville, and burning hundreds of structures, including the one that you're watching go up in flames right before our very eyes. This is south of Superior, south side of Superior, near McCaslin, south of US 36, adding to the list of hundreds of structures damaged or destroyed by this fire. We had the mayor on live moments ago, and he told us it's in the triple digits, the numbers of structures burned. Town Hall is intact, but the mining museum and lots of homes have been destroyed. The only hotel in town, the Element Hotel, has been destroyed. It just opened a couple of years ago, and they can't yet fathom the devastation that's happened in this relatively small town, but a suburban neighborhood where you just don't see this happen.
Populated, yeah, as well as Louisville. And, you know, you did ask the mayor live on air about the Costco and the Target in that area because we were getting reports about those businesses that may have been damaged. But at the time, the mayor said those appeared to be, as he was surveying the area there, those appeared to be intact. But just a surreal live picture that we're seeing in the town of Superior right now as homes are being completely engulfed in flames right now.
Got to tell you, I have a lot of worries about this neighborhood because this is a very dense neighborhood with a lot of homes, with that wind blowing straight east in that direction. And there's really nowhere for these flames to go except for right up to these homes, and we're seeing that unfold live right here on TV. Heartbreaks for whoever owns this house because it is completely engulfed at this moment, and there's nothing anybody can do about it at this point except hope that it doesn't spread to other homes in this subdivision, which it very well may. Our Rob Lowe joining us live right now. Rob, you had to move a minute ago, but yet it looks like there's still flames pretty close to you.
They're really close. I'm right in the parking lot of Boulder Valley Christian Church, where the fire department's ordered everybody to leave, which we're going to do in about 30 seconds. But I did want to show you how close the flames have gotten. We don't know if this church is going to survive this fire, and that's why the fire department came in here with one of their trucks and ordered everybody out. Of Mike Pans, this is quite an image of this cross with the flames and the black smoke just sweeping right by it. And again, I think there's a real concern now that even this church that's brick may not survive this fire, just like so many of the homes behind it. You can really see these orange flames have just really kicked up. The smoke and the winds just have been absolutely unforgiving tonight. And so now the fire department's waving towards us. And wow, look at those flames. That is an unbelievable image. We're going to go because it does seem like it's getting closer and moving a bit south. And this is why they've asked everybody to evacuate. In Boulder Road, everything south of that has been kind of the evacuation zone. I'm wondering if they're going to have to move that even further north. We're going to get going. Jeremy, Erica, back to you guys.
Yeah, Rob, yeah, make sure you stay safe throughout this evening. I just heard from a firefighting official here in Colorado who is talking to me about some of the challenges that they're facing trying to deal with these fast-moving fires right now. One of them being right now, you know, we heard Frazier talk about this. The sun is setting right now, so they're dealing with the darkness of the night, and they're also in unfamiliar areas because we've been hearing about departments from across the metro area joining in this firefight, and so it may be an unfamiliar area with them, making situational awareness very difficult for them at this point, and also safety, firefighter safety as well. They mentioned, and perhaps Frazier and Jeremy can speak to this, he says, you know, it's the Black Forest and Waldo Canyon fires are good examples of this.
Right.
Saying small fires smoldering in mulch, you have the dry leaves, the grass, it can spread to structures in areas that have already burned over as well.
That's true.
Those two come to mind. The Waldo Canyon fire especially, that was a fire that roared through the night, came over the hill, and the homes were very tight together, similar to what we're seeing here. In the Black Canyon, which was down south, the homes were million-dollar homes. They were spread out a little more, but they were surrounded by thick vegetation, which had been dried for years, and so that was fueling the burning of the homes. But the Waldo Canyon, Jeremy, I know you remember that image at night with that camera that we had from the church, looking at the side of that foothills just burning home after home after home, nonstop all night long.
I will never forget that night, and I know people who live in that part of Colorado won't either, and just as people who live in Superior won't forget this night ever. What you're looking at live right now is not one or two, but we believe three homes burning as the winds whip our camera and whip the flames around in Superior, a place where hundreds of structures have burned in the past couple of hours, including some big downtown businesses. And there is just a lot of devastation and concern that it could continue to get worse as the night goes on. We should give you an update on the winds as they pertain to something we showed you a few minutes ago, and that was the roof that it blew off a discount fire in Arvada. Our Michael Konopasek now telling us six people were injured when that happened. Two had to be sent to a hospital. Again, six people injured when a roof collapsed there at the Discount Tire Store, 64th and Sims. Two of them sent to the hospital. So it gives you a sense of the breadth of the wind this afternoon. It is not limited to Boulder County. We've been seeing it all up and down the Front Range.
And what a dangerous wind event this is turning out to be, not just in Superior and Louisville, but throughout the metro area as well. Earlier, we were reporting on semi-trucks that have flipped over on major highways. We saw highway closures as well. And on that note, in terms of the impact, the widespread impact this wind event is having, we've also been keeping in close contact with Xcel. At last check, they said more than 25,000 customers were without power and impacted in Superior, Boulder, Louisville, and Arvada as well. We just learned that Governor Jared Polis is going to speak. Again, he has declared a state of emergency because of the grass fires that we're seeing in Boulder County. We do expect to hear from him in just a moment. They are getting the microphones ready to go for the governor, and we hope to get some official information.
It's been a busy afternoon for the governor, and not only has been dealing with this, he also, as you may have heard, commuted the sentence of Rahel Aguilera Medeiros within the last hour. He, of course, the I-70 driver, sentenced to 110 years in prison for killing four people in a crash a couple of years ago. His case sparked outrage across the country. Those who said the sentence was too harsh. The governor apparently agreed, commuting the sentence this afternoon from 110 years to 10 years. In prison. So that's another big newsmaker for the governor today. But his focus a minute from now will be what's going on in Boulder County with these fires that burn even as we speak. The governor speaking with reporters any minute now here in Boulder.
Okay, we're going to listen in, folks.
A harrowing day in Boulder County with two significant fires fueled by dry conditions and very high winds. We currently have thousands of individuals in the south part of our county and in the areas of Superior and Louisville who have been evacuated. We know that there are structures, both homes and businesses, that have been burned and lost. I'm speaking about hundreds of structures. We know that people are anxiously waiting for word about the conditions of their homes and their neighborhoods. I want to assure you that our fire personnel are working as hard as they can to save additional structures as we speak. And when it's safe to do so, we'll start the emotional and painful process of assessing damages. The two fires started late this morning. The first fire, called the Middle Fork Fire, was reported just before 10:30 near the intersection of North Foothills Highway and Middle Fork Road. That fire was attacked pretty quickly and laid down later in the day and is currently being monitored. There are no reports of structures lost for the Middle Fork Fire. The second fire, the Marshall Fire, was reported just after 11 o'clock a.m. at South Foothills.